necessarily going to be wood, but I want to have wood as the kind of bottom structure. Got some ideas as to what how this is going to look, but I'm mostly kind of playing it by ear. Also, I'm going to need some more wood, aren't I? maybe, yeah, I mean, I would definitely think so, but we got a fair amount. would say that while on the whole, you know, a lot of people are absolutely fantastic in interviews, I do have some advice if you are perhaps going for an interview. Now, it doesn't matter what job you go for, whether the job pays the kind of minimum wage or, you know, whether it's your dream job. Always dress smartly. I've had a lot of people who come to interviews and they are just wearing, like, you know, jeans and a t-shirt, because, you know, that is a very bad impression. It's not to say that I wouldn't employ somebody who wears that, but, you know, you better be pretty spectacular in the rest of the interview to have a chance, basically. Also, one of the things which kind of annoys me is people who try to say things that they think you want to hear. So, a lot of people tend to use they tend to use language which isn't, you know, which wouldn't be in their normal vocabulary. So, say words that they think you want to hear, when the reality is, you know, you ask them questions about stuff and you want to hear what their honest answer is. Now, yeah, sure, you know, everybody tries to kind of coach themselves to, you know, get a job and do stuff like that, but, you know, it doesn't come across as totally honest and it doesn't come across as being relaxed, you know. I think the compound looks really good, actually. Very nice. I like the way it contours with the heels as well. Yeah, very nice. Let's get some sleep though and then crack on in the morning. So yeah, as I was saying, people tend to use language which they think they want you to hear, they think you want to hear, which perhaps isn't, you know, the kind of type of words or sentences which they would just use on a kind of normal daily basis. And I don't know, for me personally, I prefer people to be a bit more honest in interviews. Maybe that's just me about things, you know. So if you ask them a question, I generally don't mind. You know, we have kind of set questions which we ask people, but the truth of the matter is, in a lot of them, there's no right or wrong answer. It's just about people's interpretations. And, it's more about seeing the way they think than actually what the right answer is. So you want someone to be, you know, quite honest with the way they answer. And it could be that they say something that you kind of disagree with, or, you know, but if I've always believed that someone kind of justifies something, if someone backs something up, you know, then I'm quite happy for them to kind of disagree with me if they've got a good point to make. Even in a job interview. In fact, that would impress me a lot more than somebody just kind of agreeing with everything I say. And also, the other thing is, if you're in a job interview and you think to yourself, oh, you know, I didn't realise that this was something that I might have to do, or, you know, or do something like that, then it's always best to kind of say that, because there's nothing worse than employing somebody and then a few weeks later they turn around and say, oh yeah, you know, I didn't realise that this or X, Y, or Z was going to happen. And you think to yourself, well, I'm pretty sure I kind of said that to you during the interview. It's a bit weird how you're, you know, just kind of bringing it up now. And I think a lot of people kind of focused upon getting the job without really thinking whether or not it's the right job for them. And it's okay to turn around and say, you know what, I don't think this is quite right for me. It's perfectly fine. I've done that before in jobs, you know, right? Taking a job and then being like, well, you know, this wasn't quite what I thought it was going to be. But it is annoying if you kind of interview somebody and you say things to them during the interview and then because in cinemas you can work sometimes quite late, and you can say that to somebody, and you'll say, you know, are you kind of aware you might have to work until sort of 3-4 in the morning sometimes? You know, is that going to be okay? And, you know, 99% of the time it's, yeah, no problem. And then, you know, a lot, most of the time, you know, the people, they don't have a problem. To your team, but then on occasion, the people who are like kind of thinking to themselves, well, I'll say, yeah, it's fine, and then perhaps, you know, I'll only have to do it on, you know, very few occasions or whatever, or I could always, you know, get out of doing it by, you know, saying I can't work there, or, you know, doing these things, and, you know, it just leads to more problems in the long run. My advice is always be honest during a why am I using spread? Always be honest during a job interview. You know, because going for a job interview and starting a new job, you know, is kind of a bit like moving house. It, you know, it's a lot of effort to get going, but once you're in there, you're in. So, you know, if you'll keep constantly moving around jobs because you can't find the right one, you know, you're gonna stress yourself out way more than you should ever do, because, you know, you're constantly moving, constantly having to be trained in the job, and also, you know, on your CV, you know, your resume, or resume, as Lord Alan Sugar calls it, you know, that won't look very good, because people will be going, why does this person keep changing their job all the time? And you could have legitimate reasons for it, but, you know, a lot of the time, view that with suspicion in jobs. So, you know, something to kind of bear in mind. So yeah, always dress smartly, always be honest, and don't be afraid to kind of say, this job isn't for me. The other thing as well is to be punctual to your job interview, but not too punctual. I get a lot of people who I'll say have a job interview lined up. Let's say it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and the person will turn up at like 12:30, and you might think that that's good. You might think, oh well, that's great, you know, I'm just going to turn up early, it shows that I'm a punctual person. For me, it doesn't really show that you're a punctual person. What it shows me is that you didn't know how to get to your job interview, and so you got there really early. You know, I always get to job interviews early, maybe half an hour early, and then I'll go maybe have a coffee or a tea or something before it starts, and then go and never arrive more than say 10 minutes early to it. Always arrive early, definitely, 100%, but don't arrive too early. I bet that was an end of Mel God missed. Yeah, because also as well, you know, a lot of people, a lot of interviewers will be doing multiple interviews in the day, and, you know, they could already be in another interview, and then, you know, a lot of the time, for example, I'll schedule an interview, say, every 45 minutes. The interview will take about 30 minutes, and then I'll do the kind of paperwork afterwards, and maybe, you know, have a quick, you know, cup of tea or something, while, I wait for the next interview. But if that person kind of turns up early, then I'm a bit like, oh, you know, I have to kind of rush a little bit and get round and do this kind of thing. You know, especially if they arrive super early as well. So I always suggest, and also I think it's better as well to kind of have a little wander around the surroundings that, you know, if you're potentially going to be taking a job somewhere, it's nice to know. It's nice to know where it is you're working, and you know, the kind of area, what it's like, because it may help you, you know, in the interview, you know, especially if, you know, if it's a job of, you know, which is a, you know, quite a major job, you know, the chances are, you know, you may have already visited the site you're going to be working in, or, you know, done things like that, so it's good to get a lay of the land as well, definitely. firstly, check it for spelling mistakes. Check it for the way it's laid out. I had one the other day, and I'm not even joking. They obviously had a template which they used offline, which is fine. No problems. I use online templates all the time, you know. But they hadn't deleted the template, and the whole thing was just a massive mess. It was terrible. Now this person might have been really good. They might have been a really, you know, smart person, punctual, hard worker. But all that resume gives off is an air that they don't have a clue what they're doing. So make sure you check yours. Get somebody else to check it over if you can as well. Have a read through, and don't make it too long as well. Also, don't feel like you have to put, people always put kind of what their hobbies and things are, you know, and I seem to read like, you know, tens of these, and it's always, I enjoy going to the cinema, I enjoy listening to music, I enjoy watching movies and TV, and it's like, that everybody in the entire world does that. Like, there isn't anybody else. That's nothing that is making you special. If you put on there, I enjoy listening to music, and, you know, I learn to play this instrument or something like that. So, oh, okay. Or I create music in my spare time, you know, whatever. You're like, ah, that's interesting. Or if you're like, I love watching movies, you know, I enjoy, you know, making videos on YouTube or, you know, something like that. And, you know, I had one the other day where a guy was like, one of the questions is, what's your proudest achievement, you know, that you've done to kind of get to know people and get to know, you know, what sort of things they enjoy and like doing. And this guy said, oh, I made a video on YouTube and it got like 250,000 views. I was like, cool, that's brilliant, that's interesting. If he'd have said, just kind of made a video with my friends, and, or if he was like, yeah, I just enjoy making videos or something like that, you know, it wouldn't be very interesting. So never put anything like, you know, I enjoy going to the cinema, or I enjoy listening to music, because I just haven't really met anybody who doesn't enjoy that. You know, it's a given. It's like saying I'm a human being. It's like, yes, I'm, I would guess you are. So definitely do that, you know. Always let people know if you're in some sort of sports team or something like that, you know. And, you know, don't be afraid if you don't have that many hobbies, you know, or you don't really want to give away what your hobbies are, you know. You know, for example, I probably wouldn't in my position put, oh, I make YouTube videos, you know. Well, I might put that actually, but I probably wouldn't say, yeah, that ASMR videos, and I, you know, muck around in Minecraft. Be like, oh, you know, people who don't understand that sort of culture, they might be a bit wary of it. But, you know, if I just put, yeah, I make and edit videos and upload them to YouTube and, you know, do that sort of thing, then people are like, oh, that's interesting, you know, that guy's got a hobby, you know, which he learned and, you know, did that. Or, you know, you might say, just playing video games, and that's really cool, but try to look at the aspects that would help you in your job for that. Now, what do I need to do for this barn? I'm thinking to myself that I'm going to do an outer frame. I think I'm going to frame out of logs. Okay, so I'm gonna isn't how you're going to drive normally, you know. They always say you have to have your hands 10 to 2 on the wheel, you know, but realistically, as soon as you get out driving, you know, you can have one arm on the wheel, the other arm kind of hanging out the window, you know, trying to drive along looking cool. Maybe that's a bit extreme for some people, but, you know, it's kind of like going for a job. You know, you don't go to the interview. Lottery's grew here, didn't they? You know, you don't go along, you know, thinking I completely lost my train of thought there. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, make sure you dress smart, even if you're not the smartest person on earth. If it's a job you really want, make sure you've had your hair cut recently as well. Make sure that's smart. Make sure you pull out all the stops, because the thing is, you only get one chance in a job interview, you know. It's that moment to impress. So if you really want that job, if you really go for it, then make sure you do your best and put, you know, you're the best side of you forward, because there will be other people out there who will be going for the same job and they will do the same. It's a competition, basically, you know. It'd be nice if everybody could go out and just get their perfect job, but they can't. And my advice as well is that if you do, say, get a job, if you're young, if you're, you know, in your teens or early 20s, maybe you're a student and you need a job to, you know, for money to go out and enjoy yourself with and stuff like that, and it's just, you know, it's not something you're going to be doing for the rest of your life, treat that job with as much respect as you would treat the job of your dreams, because working is like a habit, you know. Being punctual, you know, working hard, they're habits, and you'll take with you those habits into your next job. And you know, your next job could be your dream job. It could be the one you've after, the one you've studied for years. And if you turn up and, you know, you're used to rocking into work late, just kind of skiving off a bit, you know, those habits will follow you, those bad habits you pick up. So, you know, you might not really care too much about the job you have, you know, but when you're at work, or, you know, before work, make sure you do, because, you know, it will help you in the future. You know, treat every job like it's your last job, basically, because you never know, it could be. Never know what's going to happen. I had a completely different career path when I was younger of what I wanted to do. I literally picked up a part-time job working in a bar, and from then, you know, they offered. one's ever angry if you're leaving because, you know, you go, you found a better job or whatever. Or, I've got another axiom I have. Okay, let's chop some more trees. If you're leaving because you found a better job or you just want to do something different, or perhaps even, you know, this job is affecting your studies and, you know, you want to concentrate on them, it's absolutely fine. It's not a problem. You know, you'll have a notice period to work, usually not longer than a couple of weeks. I always say, never ever burn your bridges. Work as hard during your notice period as you did, you know, normally, because you never know what's going to happen down the line. You might have a job there where one day you might want to go back to it. And if they're like, oh, you know, their last memory of you is going to be that notice period you worked, you know, you're going to get judged on that. You know, you might have worked there for 4 years and, you know, you might have worked super hard, but you might have been like, for the last 2 weeks, you might have been like, oh, well, I'm leaving soon. Do I really need to do this? Or it doesn't matter if I'm, you know, 10 minutes late to work. Trust me, you will get judged on the last 2 weeks. And if you can walk out of your job with your head held up high, you know, you will be able to walk back in there with your head held up high. And, you know, people, look at these guys, still sheared. You know, people will take you back in a heartbeat if you're that sort of person. I remember a good few years ago, I was leaving a job I had as a restaurant manager, and it was literally my final day. I'd done 5 weeks notice, which was the kind of normal period I had to give, and I was moving on to another restaurant. And on that day, my final day, I was working, I think, 9 till 5, so I was doing the morning. The freezer broke down in the afternoon. Now, I could have just been like, well, you know what, it's my last day, so long guys, good luck. You know, hope everything works out. It's a damn shame that happened. But it didn't. I didn't get out of there until 8 o'clock that night, because I was helping them transfer goods around and, you know, getting other, you know, restaurants to help us out. So I recommend fully that, you know, you work as hard during your notice period as you do, you know, during the rest of your time. They're my top tips for having a job. Also, don't be despondent if things don't work out the way you think they're going to work out. Job, you know, that you really wanted, you've gone for the job interview, you didn't get it. You know, it sounds like a cliche, but you know, just, you have to keep picking yourself up and keep going. You know, there's always probably going to be somebody out there who's more qualified than you or has more experience for a job. Eventually, one day, you'll be that person. And you know, the other people. So always remember that. as a kind of structural thing. You want to go across like this. Like that. It might seem a bit weird, but yeah, I think from a structure point of view, it kind of makes a little bit more sense. Nice, the kind of thick column here. These locks are a really nice block, actually. They do look good, I think. Nice detail on them. I know we probably want to keep that, actually. Like that. As well. It's important that obviously animals do get a fair amount of sunlight when they're inside. They will have this kind of pasture outside here as well, but you know, it would be important for them, I think, to actually, I think we're a bit too long here, but that's, we can adjust that later. this kind of structure here that will allow them to. How many have we got across here? So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So if we leave a one gap here, so we need another 1, 2, 3, 1. That seems to be too wide, doesn't it? We may not be able to get all four in here. That's fine, actually, when I'm thinking about it. Because what can we put in there? Sheep, cows, pigs. And then, of course, the chickens would have a separate kind of coop, wouldn't they? That's what I'm thinking. So, and then 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3. So, let's think about this. So what I'm thinking is we have a fence down here for them. Then there's three wide, and then we have a fence down here for them. And then we'll have a gap so that we can get down. And then we'll have another fence. Then we'll have it three wide. Then we'll have another fence. So actually, space to do a four wide. If we do, so yeah, we have kind of two here, and there we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, there, and then we actually have this, so we'll have the fence go down there, four wide, fence go down there. Longer if we actually. The question is, do I want to have a gap in between the pens, or do I want them kind of right next to each other? I'd like some sort of walkway gap, I think, in which case I think we need this two wide, or even three wide actually. We need it. Goes 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3 wide, so. Side, I think. No, it won't be, because we're too close to the wall then, to move this out one here, and then we'll have exactly the right amount, and we can build ourselves a separate.